Hi guys, in today's video we are going to continue from where we stopped. Remember in last class we discussed about sets, the presentation of sets, and we discussed about the types of sets we have. But in today's class we are going to solve examples from sets. And in today's class we use this one as our first example, which means that P is this, where X is an integer. Are subsets of the universal sets. If the universal set exists, use this information to find P in your key. From our previous one, this is a builder notation, which is a way of presenting sets using certain rules. This is a root, this is a rule, which is going to use us to find our element, that is the member or the value of this set. And this is another. From the first one there, we have P equals to 2x, but this range, we have this range to be, the range is from 1 inclusion to 5, which means we have 1, we have 2, we have 3, 4, and 5 itself. But because of 2x at the back, our x is no more 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then our x is times 2 of whatever we have here, and that's the end of that 2x. So therefore, we are going to be 2 times 1 is going to give us 2. 2 times 2 is going to give us 4. Remember that we are given boundary of 1 to 5, which means that 2 times 3 is supposed to give us 6, but because the boundary is 5, which means that we must not have anything greater than 5. And that's where we stop. And notice one thing, anything we multiply, any number we multiply with 2, it always gives us even number. And this is what we always use to represent even number. This 2x is telling us that this one is even number. Why this one is telling us that this one is a odd number? So for Q now, our Q will now be, remember the boundary of Q2, we have it to be 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. But which means that our range is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. But because this one is a prime number, which means that any prime number in that range from 2 to 8 is the required value. Let's say we have the first number to be 2. 2 plus 1 is going to give us 3. Then it's invalid. The next number is 3. 3 plus 1 is going to give us 4. Because this one is telling us that it's the prime number, then we won't include 4. Then we have 4. 4 plus 1 is going to give us 5. Then 5 is in the range. Because it's not up to, it's not greater than 8. Then we have 3. 3 plus, okay, we are done with that one, we are done with 4, which is 5. Now we have 5. 5 plus 1 is going to give us 6. Then we won't use it because it's an even number. Then we have 6. 6 plus 1 is going to give us 7. Then we use 7. Then we have half. We have the next number to be 7. 7 plus 1 is going to give us 8. But 8 is an even number. So it's not included. Therefore, this is our P and this is our Q. Now we now ask us to find P in your Q. Q in your Q is whatever you can find in P. Remember, we have discussed that one in the previous class. Whatever you can find in P and Q is a member of the union set. Therefore, we have P in your Q to be, we have 2, we have 3, we have 4, we have 5, and we have 7. And that is the value for our P in your Q. Okay, let's use this one as our second example. Example 2, if A is x and x is a factor of 72, then x is b is this, that is 1 over 2x plus 3 less than 2x minus 3, and c is x which is less than 20. And a, b, c are subsets. Remember, I told you that this is subset, this is superset, this is a complete proper subset of universal set, and universal set is integer, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Our normal number list the element of A intersection B intersection C. Solution. We need to write all this one to the accept builder notation, which means that certain rules is given in order to find the element. For A, the multiple of 72, or the factor of 72 is anything that can divide 72 without any data. Therefore, we have 1, we have 2, we have 4. We have our factors of 72. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 9, 12, 18, 24, 26, and 72.
are those number that can divide 62 down to the remainder. That's the name of the factor. But for this one, it is given in form of equation. Step number one, we need to rearrange the equation in order to get a single information.
We have 1/2 x. But let's take it comes to this side, let's take x comes to this side, have -2 x less than -3 -3. Therefore, this one is given 1/2 x minus 2 x less than 6. This same bracket. Therefore, we have it to be 1/2 x times 2 - 2 x times 2 less than.
Thank you.